Hello and welcome to another video for Linmob.net. Today it's about convergence. And because I'm talking about convergence today, I'm going to start by building a software that is called FOM. It's created by Guido Ginter from Purism, who's also the lead developer, as far as I know, of FOSH and FOC, and those two stand for Phone Shell and Phone Compositor. So FOM is Phone Mouse. This video is only going into convergence with FOSH. I will get into convergence with other desktops or mobile environments later in later videos. So I'm now installing this, and I think I need to go sudo for that. Yes. And now it's installing. So now I have got the software installed. So let's switch back to the phone, which isn't totally in the picture here, but it's, well, it's a difficult setup for me. So I hope that this is somehow working for you. So this is my PinePhone running Arch Linux ARM. This is a Pine64 convergence dock, which I'm actually quite happy with. And here, I hope you can see it, is a new icon called Virtual Mouse. And I'm going to start that app. Let's see how long that takes. If it starts, who knows? Could also start it from the terminal, by the way. Okay, doesn't really seem to run here. It has a protocol error. Maybe I'm missing some environment variable or something. Well, that's unfortunate. I didn't test that before. So the general setup, as you can see, is the launcher is just on the phone, and you have the apps on the large screen. I'm now going to switch to using not this dock, which doesn't work for me at all. Not that one, which sort of works, but I don't have a display port cable, so I can't really tell. By the way, this is the HP Elite X3, which has a screen size of 5.96, and the PinePhone is 5.95, as you know. And really, aspect ratio makes quite a difference if you compare those two in size. But yeah, this is a 2016 phone. It runs a Windows phone, and there's no Android port or anything, so it's really boring. But the accessories are nice. This dock is really, really great. If I could get that to work, that would be wonderful. And but now you're going to see this one. So here we go again. I switched the position of my camera, and so let's see how we can use this HP Elite X3 dock, which I think was sold in 2016. And yeah, so let me just briefly unlock that one, and now let's swipe to unlock. Enter the stupid code, and here we go. Yeah. And now I want to show you something else, because one of the problems, well, let's first open Firefox so that I can browse a bit. And then, yeah, moving it over to the other screen is by pressing super or Windows and shift and the right arrow key. And now I've got the Firefox window on this screen, and it's full screen. We because that's the mobile config, I think, that does that. We can also use super and the arrow keys to, well, put it to the left or the right, but apparently that can go wrong. Now, I don't know what happened there. One of my problems here is that this cable is actually a bit flaky, so let's see. But it's good that this happens now, because, well, I want to show you how it really is. I really think it's the cable, but I unfortunately don't have another fully wired micro USB cable, but it looks like it doesn't really re-recognize the dock here. Does it? Okay, now the dock's restarting. Let's see. Okay, works again. Great. I was almost giving up hope and thinking about restarting here. So let's just do it like this. And then I also need a terminal. Not going to show you the camera here because, well, that would be useless. So, yeah. So now we've got a terminal and a browser. So pretty much standard tiling window manager setup. And now let's see. Purism recently had a post about app IDs that programs are supposed to supply to help with convergence, so that you don't have to do what I have to do here now, and that is cleaning up the launcher. But then that's something you are going to need to do every now and then anyway, I think, if you're building software on your phone at least. So I will just go to a folder, and that is important if you want to do anything about the number of apps that are in this launcher. And that is, now I have to choose that window again, and that is pretty clunky. I don't know why it's like that. So it's /local or /home/user/.local, and then share applications. In this folder, as you can see, are a bunch of desktop files which are already edited. So let's just briefly have a look at one totally unrelated app to convergence here, which I tweaked a bit, and that is Telegram Desktop. Because that one, you can have it scale properly if you add a dash scale and then a percentage value, like 80, without the percent sign, and have it scale properly and have it be usable on mobile. So that's something I would recommend if you are a Telegram user. Now, of course, Telegram is, well, not totally open source. Server isn't open source, so yeah, maybe some people are telling you you shouldn't use it, and I agree, but, well, there's a lot of communications regarding PinePhone stuff I would miss out on without it. So, yeah, I'm using that also for other projects. You can't always choose the tools that are being used now. But let's now stop talking about Telegram, and I need to tap there again. Then this window is actually active, and do another ls. Maybe let's clear here, and then I will show you briefly how to modify or how to copy over a launcher. Now, this one, this cute QDBus viewer, I don't need that. It's a developer tool, I guess. It gets installed when you compile Qt apps on your device, which I did for Anglefish and Calendari. And yeah, so I need to get the focus here, and then I will just type cp for copy, go to user, share, applications, and then it's, I think, qdbusviewer.desktop, and I type dot so that it this file gets copied into my folder. Again, I'm in local/local/.local/home user.local/share/applications. And if I now edit that file, I can now edit it, and I will just use page down and A for append, and then type no display equals true, escape, colon, WQ, and I hope this worked. Yeah, it worked. And again, sorry for the flaky cable, but that launcher is gone now. Isn't that a win? So that's basically how we can clean up a bit if there's too much stuff in there. And now I wanted, of course, to show you this initiative. I think it was on their blog. Of course, they've published a whole bunch of other crap since. Ugh. Yeah. I should have prepared that better. I'm sorry. Here, there it is. That is specify form factors in your Librem 5 apps. And the same applies basically, or could apply, to the PinePhone. And would certainly be helpful, because there are no official, there's no freedesktop.org standard yet. So I think people should just adopt it, or adopt it in a refined way. So this is really something that helps. So it's another key for that .desktop entry, which basically helps with displaying an app or not. So let's just see what that would mean. So, and if it works already, because again, we are using fork here, so it might be actually activated. So let's just, let me think of an app that doesn't really work well on mobile. Well, GIMP. I have GIMP installed. I don't know what the name of that .desktop file is, but I will just briefly list all the files in that folder where I expect it to be, and grep GIMP. And see, there, it's GIMP desktop, so that's so simple I could have guessed it. But yeah, it's not always. Sometimes it could have been org.gimp .gimp or something. So yeah, great that it's so easy. And now let's edit the local copy. The reason to do that is not just because you don't have to run sudo with your editor to edit it then, but when there's an update of the application, otherwise the .desktop file would get replaced, and like this, it doesn't. And so your change survives updates, which is, I think, quite great, actually. So, yeah, I will just add the key, well, where will I add it? I don't think they've specified a place, so I will just do so here, inserting a line, and go xpurism form factor equals workstation, right? Because it's one of those apps that is utterly useless if I don't run it on locally. So let's see. Now let's start GIMP. Let's take the touchpad here and go over to GIMP. I hope I hit the Right. I can there. Oh, that looks promising. Yeah. So let's hope that's it, right? I need to make sure it's in focus, and then bam, I can move it over and I can like open and say edit one of my screenshots. Well, it's mostly boring. You've seen those if you're following me on Twitter. But I could like edit a picture I took with my PinePhone. I could also demo Darktable or Raw Therapy here because of those raw files, but and I don't know what image will open now because the preview doesn't show quick enough. Yeah, thankfully it's nothing persons from my private life, so I'm not got lucky here. And now, yeah, okay, I think that's I'm going to keep that color profile, and yeah, that's Munich's Olympiaturm. It's for TV broadcasting, and there's a restaurant in there. And I could now edit this file with the GIMP, like, I don't know, place a stupid text on it, saying, stupid linmob test, which is of course something you totally shouldn't do, and then save it. Oh, and it's going to save it as a XCF file. Yeah. And we're done there. By the way, I could also increase here size. So I mean, it's actually GIMP works quite well considering this is really not a high-end phone. Makes me quite happy. I'm almost tempted to do more, and I don't know, maybe try to fix colors or something, but I don't work much with GIMP anymore, so I'm really not sure what I should be doing here. Well, I could of course desaturate it, color to gray. No, that sounds fine for me. So let's see how long that runs. Okay, that takes a bit, but the great thing is it works. Your phone is a computer now. And you can use the open source tools you're used to from your Linux desktop, which I think is quite something now. Is it actually going to show me this in grayscale now? I thought it should be grayscale now. Why isn't it? Well, anyway, by the way, I think the level of detail of the PinePhone camera with megapixels, which is of course the excellent app by Martin Bram, I think that's how he pronounced his name, is actually great. Oh yeah, it only converted it only converted the text to grayscale, and that took that long. That's funny. So let's redo the same thing for the actual image. So now I'm back here, and yeah, unfortunately my phone I'm recording this with ran out of storage again, and so yeah, it's second take now, and now camera's always moving off here, so I'm going to have to hold it. The image converted to grayscale properly here, and yeah, so That's quite nice. And the level of detail of the megapixels camera is actually, yeah, it's not too bad. I mean, given how terrible the pictures the PinePhone took were earlier, I think that's pretty much fine. Now, there are two more things I need to get into. The first thing is PeerTube. Now, my videos are also on library, but they are on PeerTube now too, and I'm going to publish them there first for a limited time, at least for a trial period if you want, in order to promote this platform, because I think PeerTube is a nice alternative to YouTube. The order of videos is a bit off there. But they are all very loud now, so I increased the volume like I did on my newer videos before publication here, so, and yeah, uploaded them as I saw fit. That's why this is a mess, and there's a relatively old video relatively far up here and so on. But yeah, so if you're watching this video on launch date, you're watching it on PeerTube. And if you're only on YouTube, please check out PeerTube too. Also, I've got a question. Now, with apps like GIMP running fine or relatively fine in convergence mode, do you think that needs another list, or is that something that's not necessary? Because otherwise I would like to extend Linmob apps with another special list for those apps that have been tested in convergence mode. Please let me know. Also, I still have got... There's been nobody who wants to make a games list, so I'm just gonna branch out the games, I think, and never look at them again, and nobody's going to care. But, well, then that's that. That's fine with me. So, as long as I don't have to tackle and see all this while I'm going through the list, I'm like, oh god, not another game that I will not find anywhere packaged. Yeah, it's going to make my maintenance easier. Anyway, now, next post on my blog is going to be up on this Sunday at the latest. Maybe I'm going to make a post on convergence accompanying this video, but yeah, let's see about that. And then there's one more thing I wanted to test now, and that is whether that indicator I added to that GIMP launcher file now actually works already. So let's just do this and see what happens then. Oh, it's still docked, but then it's in maximized mode, so that doesn't do anything. So we have to disconnect the dock here, and yeah, take the phone into the end, scroll, and yeah, it's still there, that icon. I don't know, maybe I should have read the instructions before making this video, but that's good to know. It's not that easy yet. So let's discard the changes here in GIMP. And yeah, I'm going to talk more about the apps on this screen, about some of them in a later video, maybe. Also, one more thing, oh, which I totally forgot, sorry for that, is that you can also, if you don't want to have that launcher on the phone all the time, which especially if you're connected to a bigger screen, can be, I think, well, quite annoying even. Let's hope it turns on. Is it really plugged in? Oh no. Is it working? Yeah, it looks like it might be working any second now. Yeah, it works, but second time connecting, you sometimes get a weird too low resolution. But yeah, I'm just going to start in a terminal session. And okay, now screen is off, but at least you can perfectly see that text. I'm positive. And run render. Oh god. just turn it into that mode so that I see all of that screen, and then of course I forgot the entire syntax. And this touchpad really is the worst part of that dock. Tell me about that. Yeah, now it's working. Oh no. So run help. Okay, it's output. You can run output DSI dash one dash dash off, and then you're just using the screen and the launcher. Usually it would scale properly, is because when the dock works with full HD resolution, it isn't that like that, is then on your screen, so you've got better multitasking and working abilities. And let me just briefly see if that maybe re-enables that virtual mouse. Though I doubt it, unfortunately. I doubt it. I think I just compiled it in a state where it, yeah, unfortunately it doesn't seem to work currently on the PinePhone. Yeah, so thanks for your patience, and see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye. Have a great week, despite of all the circumstances.